A very good morning, children. Our next revision chapter is lesson number 5, the Southern Plateaus and the Highlands. We discussed in the first chapter that India can be divided into 5 physical divisions, namely the Northern Mountains or the Himalayan ranges in the north. Then we have the Great Indian Plains or the Northern Plains as well as the Coastal Plain. The Northern Plains, as you know, it is in the southern part of the Himalayan range, and there are 2 coastal plains, namely the Western Coastal Plain as well as the Eastern Coastal Plain, which are one of the most fertile regions of our country. Then we discuss about the Western Desert, which is also known as the Great Indian Desert or the Third Desert. And now in this chapter, we are going to discuss about the 2 other physical divisions, that is the Southern Plateaus as well as the 2 islands. Children, talking about the Southern Plateau, if you look at this map carefully, you will see our Northern Plains. Just to the south of the Northern Plains lies the Southern Plateau. As you can see, it is in mostly in the central as well as the southern part of India. So this plateau is divided into 2 parts, that is the Central Highlands and the Deccan Plateau. Central Highlands and the Deccan Plateau. We are going to discuss about the Central Highlands, which is just, you know, the southern part of the Northern Plains to the river Narmada. And the Deccan Plateau is from the Narmada River to the southern tip of our country. This Southern Plateau is triangular in shape, and it is very rocky and uneven. If we take the 2 division of our Southern Plateau, the Central Highlands and the Deccan Plateau. The Central Highlands are surrounded, as you can see in the map, by the Aravalli Hills towards the northwest, the Vindhya Range towards the south, the Chotanagpur Plateau towards the east, and the Rajamahal Hills towards the northeast, and the Malwa Plateau in the center. As you can see this, this is our Central Highlands. As you can see, the Northern Plains, the Third Desert, you have Aravalli, you have Vindhyas, you have Chotanagpur Plateau, and this is still Narmada River. Then comes the Deccan Plateau. As Deccan Plateau, children, the Deccan Plateau extends from river Narmada to the southernmost tip of our peninsula, southernmost tip of the peninsula, okay? And we discussed the 2 coastal plains, and this 2 plains actually meet. These, or you can call it the 2 ghats. The coastal plain actually lies between the western coastal plain lies between the western ghat and the Arabian Sea. The eastern coastal plain actually lies between the Bay of Bengal and the eastern ghats. And this ghats, these 2 ghats, as you can see, the western ghat and the eastern ghat, they meet at Nilgiri Hills. They meet at Nilgiri Hills, children, Eastern Ghats and Western Ghats. And Anai Mudi is their highest peak here. Anai Mudi is the highest peak, which is in Kerala Munnar. Okay? And these, here many rivers flow in the Southern Plateau, but these rivers are not as long as the Northern Plains like Ganga, Satluj or Yamuna or Brahmaputra. But they are little, means, not as long, and they also don't have perennial, they are not, they cannot be called perennial rivers because they do not have water throughout the year. Now in Central Highlands you have the important rivers like you have Chambal, you have Betwa, you have Son, and in the Deccan Plateau the main rivers or the important rivers are you have Godavari, you have Krishna, Kaveri, Mahanadi, as well as this Godavari is the longest river, or it is called the Southern Ganga because it is the longest river in the Deccan Plateau. Here you can see Anai Mudi, the highest peak in the Southern Plateau. This is Nilgiri Hills where the Western Ghats and the Eastern Ghats meet. This is your Sahyadri Range, Karamakoram Hills. All these are in the Southern Plateau, children. So this is all about the Southern Plateaus. Life in this region, as you know, the states we are going to discuss are Madhya Pradesh, then we have Maharashtra, Karnataka, then you have Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, Tamil Nadu, Chhattisgarh, Jharkhand. These are the some of the states which lie in this southern plateau, children. And these are very important states, and they are very rich in different forest products as well as the island, children. This islands, two island groups in India are our the Andaman and Nicobar Island, which is located in the Bay of Bengal, and we have the Lakshadweep Island, which is located in the Arabian Sea. So these are the two islands, and children, these islands are also very good for farming, and good beaches are there, and you have cellular jail, which is very famous in Andaman and Nicobar Islands, and good places to visit over there. And so all these make up our southern plateau and the islands, okay. And this island, Andaman and Nicobar Island, children, it is a group of islands, okay. And this very hilly region, also there the island is very hilly, and the 10 degree channel actually divides Andaman and from Nicobar. Even Lakshadweep is also a group of island, and its capital, as you know, is Kavarati. Andaman's capital is Port Blair. So all these make up our different features of our country: the Himalayan mountains, the northern plains, the coastal plain, the Great Indian Desert, as well as the southern plateaus and the central highlands. Okay, so this is all about our physical features. Thank you, children.